SpaceX's Raptor engine exploded during its testing phase. While this news may seem alarming, it may not be a significant issue. In fact, it may indicate important progress in preparation for the upcoming lunar mission. Meanwhile, SpaceX's Starbase continues to thrive, with numerous upgrades and developments underway. Let's discuss all of this in today's NR Studio episode. When we think of SpaceX's Starship system, we tend to associate it with Starbase, the vibrant hub where assembly, testing, and launch activities converge. Starbase represents the dynamic core of the Starship initiative, illustrating the complexity, scale, and aspirations of SpaceX's upcoming space exploration technology. However, it's also important to emphasize that engine-related operations are actively underway in McGregor, Texas, and this is crucial to the success of any Starship endeavor. This location is where the Raptor engines, Starship's primary propulsion, undergo testing, refinement, and performance assessments before actual launch. Recently, a Raptor 3 engine exploded during testing at McGregor. While engine explosions may seem alarming in the context of SpaceX's development schedule, such events are not unexpected. What makes this event significant is that the explosion occurred at startup rather than during a prolonged static fire, which has been the typical scenario in previous instances. Witnessing an engine fail at startup naturally raises questions about potential defects, possibly related to local production issues or design changes. However, despite initial concerns, the likelihood of this pointing to a broader system issue is extremely low. The Raptor engines have undergone extensive testing, and previous prototypes have demonstrated exceptional reliability. This leaves two plausible scenarios. This could be a unique issue affecting only one engine, or SpaceX may have intentionally conducted high-stress tests to assess the engine's limitations. Given SpaceX's track record of deliberately stress testing to ensure mission readiness, the latter is the most likely explanation. Next year, the Raptor 3 engine will be crucial for several high-risk Starship missions. For example, Flight 12 will include the first in-space reignition of a Raptor 3 engine, a significant milestone for the initiative. Future Starship missions will involve launching payloads into orbit, establishing in-space refueling infrastructure, and executing a complex two-phase landing procedure. The success of all these operations hinges on the engine's ability to restart reliably after being shut down. Previous flights have sometimes encountered difficulties restarting the engine after extended use, so verifying this functionality in a real-world setting is vital.
The independent engine evaluation at McGregor is crucial because it gives engineers the opportunity to test the engine at its maximum capacity in a regulated environment. By deliberately pushing the startup sequence to its critical point, SpaceX can gain crucial information about the engine's performance range. This method helps identify potential flaws, allowing engineers to address them well before they jeopardize the actual mission. The lack of official comment from SpaceX regarding this latest test suggests the organization views it as a routine aspect of the development cycle rather than a warning sign. The timing of this evaluation is also crucial given SpaceX's lunar timeline. Declassified documents reveal the intention for an uncrewed lunar landing demonstration to occur in June 2027, followed by a crewed lunar landing in September 2028. Initial in-space refueling missions are slated to begin as early as June 2026. In preparation for these milestones, the 12th flight in January will focus on engine restarts, while other missions in the first half of the year will include payload deployment and a two-stage landing. Given such a demanding schedule, early testing is crucial to ensure the engine is fully functional before the critical lunar mission. The refueling task presents a distinct challenge because it needs to be executed multiple times while ensuring engine and vehicle reusability. This requires SpaceX to have a large number of engines and prototypes available for testing and improvement. By conducting thorough engine testing at this stage, the team can anticipate potential issues and make necessary improvements, thereby improving mission reliability while maintaining an adaptable schedule. In conclusion, the recent Raptor 3 engine test at McGregor, despite the explosion, was a deliberate and potentially vital step in preparation for future critical missions. It highlights SpaceX's dedication to testing practices, risk management, and readiness for the next generation of Starship activities. Supporting the SpaceX team during this critical time is crucial, and fans are encouraged to show their support by commenting "Keep up the good work" below, liking the video, and subscribing to stay updated on Starship developments and SpaceX's ambitious space exploration initiatives. The heart of all SpaceX operations lies at Starbase, which is experiencing the most extensive activity as the company begins this new phase of Starship development, testing, and launch. Let's start with the remains of the previous phase, specifically the OLM-1 platform. After the 11th flight, this platform underwent a comprehensive dismantling process. Elements such as the QD system, protective covers, clamps, and pipes were all systematically removed. On the 16th, a memorable event occurred when the first OLM stage was officially lowered.
Observing this event evokes memories of previous demolitions, including the low-rise and high-rise platforms, which represented the beginning of the Starship initiative. While it may seem disruptive, each demolition marks a significant development that enables greater innovation and capabilities. Regarding OLM Pad 1, with the demolition of the first leg, the next five legs will also undergo demolition. This procedure is expected to be completed within this week. Following the demolition of each leg, the pad area will be cleared of all debris. Once the entire old structure is removed, SpaceX will begin excavating the fire trench. Once the structural area is reshaped, crews will pour concrete, install rebar, add more concrete, construct the fire bucket, construct the OLM platform, install the BQD gantry structure, place the OLM, connect the BQD system, and complete other minor setups. Given the current pace of work, the complete upgrade of Pad 1 is expected to be completed by the middle of next year, with potential deployment in the second half of this year. It's worth noting that this schedule primarily impacts the test and launch support systems. Another aspect of Pad 1, called the chopsticks, will be operational more quickly to facilitate the capture of both Starship stages. This upgrade required shortening both arms and modifying the internal systems to align with the Starship V3 configuration, a task that is expected to be carried out fairly quickly. In contrast, Platform 2 marks a new phase and is gradually nearing completion. The latest update reveals that the BQD methane hood has been installed, likely the final major component of this system. Its installation indicates that the fuel lines have also been connected. Throughout this phase, Platform 2 has also been involved in ongoing testing along with chopsticks and the fire trench deluge system. The first static fire test is highly anticipated. Platform 2 will likely have to wait for Booster B-18 to complete its cryogenic testing and engine installation before being deployed, as Booster B-17, originally scheduled to assist in Platform 2 testing, is currently being dismantled. Regarding B-17, it represents another example of older generation equipment being phased out to make way for the next generation vehicle. Currently, the first V3 ship, S-39, is attracting significant attention. Over the weekend, the final aft section of S-39 was moved to Megabay 2 and stacked with the rest of the ship, marking a significant milestone in the completion of the first Starship V3 production run. In retrospect, the S-39 buildup began with the nose cone and payload on October 13th. The entire buildup took just 33 to 34 days, surpassing the previous fastest duration of 42 days for Starship V2.
This increased effectiveness highlights the natural progression of V3, even before any confirmed flight test related to the upgrades. Based on the experience gained during S-39, manufacturing of future spacecraft is expected to accelerate further. This is crucial as SpaceX will need multiple prototypes in the coming years to facilitate critical missions. S-39 will soon transition to cryogenic testing, as the testbed was recently relocated from the Massey test site to a production facility for this purpose. Overall, the current progress is in line with the 12th test flight scheduled for launch in January of next year. We are getting closer to the official launch of Starship V3. Its improvements, speed, and new functions are expected to be remarkable, marking the beginning of an exciting new phase in SpaceX's history. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next time.